What's going on, guys? It's Danny here. Are you ready for some Sniperino action? This is going to be my player perspective of playing Sniper. I played this game on stream, but I still can't upload it live because my stream crashed in the middle of the game. And uploading a Dota 2 gameplay in two parts, that's not really a thing, right? I don't know about that. So, this is going to be a Sniper gameplay commentary. I always start with I'm going mid lane, by the way, mid lane sniper this game. I always start with Wraith Band. It's really good early stats. Here I get a Tango. Normally the dream is to get Tango shared by the supports. My team tried to go for first blood here, but they were really split. Didn't really work very well. Lion went one way, Juggernaut went the other way. They couldn't combo stun and spin, so they didn't get first blood, unfortunately. Normally, if the support gives you two tangos, you buy two branches. I get two branches, so I plant a happy little tree and I use the tango on it to get more regen from the tango. And if I need more regen, I can use the courier to get another set of tangos or a healing salve, depending what I need. First two items, I go phase boots, finish the Ring of Aquila, and then I get another Wraith Band apart from the Ring of Aquila. I'm gonna talk about it a little bit later. A lot of you guys were asking on my gameplay videos, and even though you get replies, and you probably already know, I'm still going to say it in case some people don't know, how to add many items on the quick buy. Right now I have phase boots and I have the Ring of Aquila there. You do it with control and shift. Like with shift you add one item, but with control and shift you get second or third item. So here, looking at the enemy team, there is the disruptor already harassing me on the mid lane. And looking at the enemy team, they have a Disruptor and they have a Kunkka. Both can roam. Kunkka, I play Kunkka support and I know he's a good roamer. When you get level 3, that X mark is like 600 range, I think. That's a pretty long range. You can easily combo X mark with Torrent and set up a kill or a gank. So definitely the point is this game, I should be watching out my sides, especially my left side. You know, because if they gank me, they will always come this way. That's what you have to realize. If it was an Earth Spirit, he can come from behind. Or if it was a Mirana, she could arrow me from behind. Now apparently Kunkka is going from behind as well. The Astro and the Torrent, but I will be fine here because Torrent doesn't deal that much damage anymore. It used to deal more damage at level 1. And they don't really have damage to kill me. It was a nice gank, but they couldn't really kill me. And here, I knew they had a high ground ward. If the OD disrupts you, or no, it's not disruption, sorry, it's Astro, imprisonment. If the OD Astros you on the high ground, and normally he doesn't see you, that means he has vision on you. He has an observer ward on the high ground. Can't really kill me here. There is a disruptor rotating again. And I know he will come from the left side, up here. So I'm always trying to stay on the right side. That's important to realize. Forget this. What is going on here? Last hits? We should probably put last hits on the screen, I guess. I've been missing some. Only got 6 last hits now. Been missing some last hits. Getting myself more tangos. That's what I mean. If you need more regen, just get more regen. I'm kind of scared here. Because I know that Astro from OD and a Kunkka Torrent can kill me. But Kunkka and Disruptor, also that's another thing you can keep in mind as a mid laner. Watching the minimap, where are the enemy supports? First blood. If the enemy supports are missing and you know that they are not pulling, if you don't have Observer Ward watching them and you know that they are not pulling and they are missing from the map, then that means you should be slightly careful. If the supports are on the top lane, that means you are playing a 1v1. Okay, I said this, one second. I'm just gonna pause for 1 second. I said this. You can see the Observer Ward, by the way, on the minimap. The Observer Ward is up here. I said this on my stream, and I want to pause the game and say it in this video as well. When you play support, or worst case scenario, if you are a mid laner and you have to buy your own sentry to deward because the supports are not buying sentry and not dewarding for you, the perfect spot on the middle lane is here. Like, right here, where I'm pointing right now. If you place it here, it will cover enemy's high ground. So this ward right here would have gotten dewarded 100%. It will cover enemy's high ground. It will cover your high ground. And it will cover this spot over here. Another very common spot where people put observers. If you put your observer or your sentry right here, what I'm pointing. This is the best spot. Now, if you don't find a ward here by placing a sentry here, that means it's like here or up there, something like this, maybe. But this sentry is wasted. This sentry basically covers my high ground, but the observer is not on my high ground. You don't know where exactly the observer is. Like, I know that OD gets vision on me because he astros me when he shouldn't be able to, because he doesn't have vision without a ward. So it's obvious that there is a ward, but I don't know exactly where. I can't be 100% sure where the ward is.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
See? Normally right there, he wouldn't have vision because it's nighttime, but because of the observer, he has vision and he astros me. One thing, and I'm pinging this spot because I'm thinking the ward is there. It's not really there, but still, you can't know exactly where it is. That's why the sentry should be on a place where it covers most spots. Another thing to do, if you guys noticed earlier, when OD went for the rune, wait, there is a little fight going on here. He can't really kill me, and I can't kill him because he has haste. When OD went for the rune, I shrapneled the creep wave and pushed it into the tower. So when OD got back from taking the rune, two of my creeps died to his tier 1 tower. So that's a really good thing to do if you have an ability that pushes the wave. When the enemy mid laner goes for the rune, sometimes it's good to push it, and he will end up missing experience and farm. It's a big thing. If you out level the enemy mid laner, if you get level 6 before him, with your ultimate you can kill him before he gets his ultimate. In this case, OD's ultimate is not that important. Most people don't even skill the ultimate on OD on level 6. There are other spells that do more, that are better to skill on level 6. But normally, if you're playing against the Queen of Pain, she doesn't have ultimate on 6 and you are 6, and you have bigger kill potential on her than she has on you. You know what I mean? So all those little things like denying creeps or pushing it so enemy misses farm, those little things can end up being a kill advantage for you, and that's really big. Both supports rotating again from the left side. This time I have an observer near the Roche pit on the high ground, and I see them, so it's a lot easier for me to back up when I see them. There are the face boots. Next thing to finish will be Ring of Aquila. And here I see that Disruptor is really, really deep, diving even the tier 1 tower and the Kunk as well to kill my offlane Nyx Assassin. So we just make a rotation here, and that should be very easy kills. Ultimate, he's dead. I get gold, we all get experience. Those kind of rotations can be done. So here is the thing about the second Wraith Band after the Ring of Aquila. It's basically cheap stats that help you early. It helps a lot in the mid game fights. I have been in many situations as a sniper where 10 minutes into the game, 15 minutes into the game, just the mid game, I survive in a team fight, or if I get ganked, I survive with 50 to 100 HP. And basically those health points, those 50 or 100 are coming from the Wraith Band. If I didn't have that Wraith Band, I would have been dead there. And I just like the second Wraith Band. Raindrop as well blocks magical damage. Helps a lot in the mid-game fights. Here, Raindrop and Ring of Aquila. Also, the point of the replay, of commentating over the replays, to notice mistakes, right? If there are mistakes done, or even if there are no mistakes. I mean, everybody makes mistakes, so yeah, there will be mistakes. And I want to look on them. Right now, I could be getting a bit more efficiency from my mana regen that I get from Raindrop and Ring of Aquila. And when OD Astros a creep to farm faster and push the wave faster, I can ult him. Normally, I wouldn't ult an OD because he can Astro himself and block my ultimate. Trying to farm some jungle when the lane is pushed in. But when I see the lane pushing into my tower, I always go for it. Even if the jungle creep is half HP, not gonna finish it. Always going for the lane farm. Lane farm is much better than jungle farm. Always much better. Now this is Nyx Assassin with a very nice gank on the mid lane. I just have to ult the OD and he's dead. I'm loving the Ogre in my team as always, as a sniper. Ogre gives you bloodlust, movement speed and attack speed. That's absolutely perfect for you as a sniper. So now I can come here and finish the jungle creeps. And I can go for another jungle camp even. If I feel like the lane is in danger to farm because Kunkka and Disruptor are about to gank me, I can farm jungle. But if the lane is safe to farm, should always be on the lane. Always farm the lane. Always prioritize lane farming. If you're safe lane carry, if you're mid lane, doesn't really matter. Always the lane farm. It gives way more experience, way more farm. And by pushing it into enemy's tower, you're forcing enemies to defend the tower. And that space created, basically. You are creating space just by farming. There is a double damage, so why not just go there and pick it up? I don't see why not. I don't think, yeah, gonna rotate to the top lane and try to fight there. This Kunkka seems like the easiest kill. And now Disruptor. Can't catch the Disruptor though, he's too far and I don't have any shrapnels left for slows. Meanwhile, OD, of course, pressuring the tower. And I'm going back to my mid lane to defend the tower and farm my lane, continue farming. So the first item here is Dragon Lance. Let me see. We cannot kill the OD. No, Lion doesn't have mana for a stun. My first item is Dragon Lance. Hurricane Pike is really good on sniper in most games. Forcing yourself after a kill when chasing an enemy. Forcing yourself to escape from being killed. So So Dragonlance goes into Hurricane Pike. Okay, Ogre gets picked off here. And I don't think I can... No, I can't really get anything for this. They are camping mid a lot. Enemies hated the mid lane a lot this game. So right now the lane is pushing. And I'm actually going top. That's a really nice two-man stun. Dominating. Killing the Disruptor. Killing the Slark. Okay, that was... I should have ulted the Slark 100%. Now I think I am dead, because what can save me? Nothing. Okay. I mean, the Slark had his Pounce ready. So Pounce removes my ultimate. If I ulted him there, he would have pounced and blocked my ultimate. I don't know, that was kind of a weird situation. I will not forget this. Tipping top again. And we should be able to kill this Disruptor. Yep. I tried to ult him. He died before I even ulted him. I guess in my first death, I should have just backed after killing the OD. Didn't really have enough damage to kill the Slark there before he escapes, before he pounces away. I guess I should have backed after killing Disruptor. Now farming some neutrals again. After Dragonlance, I'm going for Maelstrom here. As I said, Hurricane Pike is really good on sniper, really useful. In most of the sniper games, it will help you a lot. But it doesn't really give you much damage. Okay, I think here is where my internet crashes and my stream crashes because I'm not moving. I got disconnected from the game, so that's when my stream crashes. I mentioned in the beginning. My stream crashed, and I don't think uploading a Dota 2 gameplay part 1 and part 2 for the same gameplay, I don't think that's a thing. It's not really a thing. Okay, so before finishing the Hurricane Pike, getting a Maelstrom will increase your farming speed because of those lightnings. You will deal more damage in fights, of course, because of the lightnings. Gives attack speed and gives a lot of damage as well. It's just Hurricane Pike is good and useful in sniper, but can't be done, like shouldn't really be done as a very first item unless it's really, really, really needed. In this game, it's needed, but like... I would say, even if it's really, really, really needed, still make a Maelstrom before finishing the Pike. Because Pike gives barely no damage. It's just utility. Survivability and utility for you and for your teammates, because you can maybe force a teammate and save his life. I think that happened in this game. Save the teammate's life with my force. So yeah, that's about the Maelstrom. I think my Ring of Aquila should be on at this point, should be active. to provide armor to creeps. When pressuring a lane, it helps. Creeps die slower if they have more armor, of course. I will realize it and I will turn it on. I will make it active at some point. I hope it's not very late. Alright, so now I'm back in the game and we are ready to continue. Looks like Nyx trying to gank OD again. But the enemies have sentries and they see him.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Okay, so what I did there was basically I forced Disruptor to go back to base. He just came to the lane and I forced him to go back to base. And even Nyx Assassin got the kill actually. He finished the kill with his Invis or something. Yeah, that was a really nice kill by Nyx. Okay, is this dangerous? Yeah, this is dangerous. Buyback? Can I get anything from this buyback? If I get kills, it's nice. But looks like we didn't really continue the fight. After I died, everybody went back. Okay. Normally a buyback like that is done to rejoin the fight, but the fight didn't continue. The fight stopped when I died. The thing is that I want to go back and see when I died. I think I had time to run away, didn't I? The OD Astro, like, first of all, my mistake here is to be out of position a little bit. I didn't know OD has 4 stuff, and it was a really good reaction by OD to force himself and Astro me. After that, Kunkka will follow up with Boat and Torrent. So I was hitting the tower on the high ground, and without that much protection, like, how much can they protect me? It's not a disruptor that can disrupt me when I'm about to get hit by the boat. Lion can disable enemies, but not really save my life when I'm getting focused by spells. Like a disruptor would with disruption. So first of all, my bad. Bad positioning. Good reaction by OD. Force Astro me. After that, they kill me. In this game, we don't really have a tanky frontliner. Any tanky hero like Axe or Centaur, those kind of tanky heroes are very good to have as a sniper. So here, I could have run, I think. Yeah, the torrent came in about a second after the Astro. Not right after the Astro. Okay, actually the fight did continue when I bought back, but when they realized I'm coming back to the fight, they backed. Slark just backed and OD just backed. So they made my buyback totally not worth it. Simply by disengaging.
I'll take that as tribute.
Okay. So now, go back to farming, I guess. Go back to farming. Nothing else can be done here. Meanwhile, Juggernaut is farming a lot, by the way. Juggernaut is completely free farming the entire game so far, 17 minutes. Nobody is contesting him. Like, enemy supports, Kunkka and Disruptor are non-stop just sitting middle. They are not doing anything else, they are just sitting middle trying to kill me. Juggernaut has 150 last hit at 17 minutes. He's out of control. I don't know if we can catch the... if we can catch the Weaver here. That's not enough damage. Actually, oh yeah, nice. Okay. Nice Nyx Assassin stun. Wait, was that a blink on Lion, by the way? Yeah, he has a blink dagger. That's a very early blink dagger as a Lion support. That's really nice. And he has only 14 last hits. What did he do to get that blink dagger with only 14 last hits? He has the minus respawn time. There is a GPM talent later, but now he has minus respawn time. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. He probably got a lot of kills on the Lion. That's how he got the blink dagger.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Oh, he's 4-0. 4 kills, no deaths, of course. Very well done. Dire's middle tower has fallen. Right now there is a fight going on the mid lane. I can't join it right away because I stayed bottom to farm after we pushed out the bottom lane. And that's a nice kill on Weaver again. So after we got two pickoffs on two core heroes, OD and Weaver, this tier 2 tower should be easy to destroy. Juggernaut is strong, Juggernaut hits really hard. He's getting fat, really, really fat. Look at the net worth right now. I'm not even close to the Juggernaut. I have more than OD, more than the enemy mid laner. But not even close to Juggernaut. There is a Slark on Shadowblade. Slark on Shadowblade. There is a Shadow Blade on Slark with Echo Saber. Okay, why am I not running towards the fight? Probably because that's not a good fight. I think at this point Juggernaut was saying to everyone, go back, go back. And I didn't even go to the fight. Nyx Assassin was trying to get the pickoff, typical Nyx Assassin stuff, but the pickoff didn't really work. I get glimpsed back here, but there is no follow-up, can't really kill me. And now Juggernaut decides to join. Okay, I'm in a really nice position here, just shooting at the OD. I mean, sorry, Disruptor. And now OD Astros himself, Shrapnel. Can't really catch anybody here. Can't catch anybody. Oh, okay, Nyx got OD. That's nice. For some reason, OD stayed to farm. He didn't back all the way to base, he stayed farming a neutral camp. And nice observer, of course, that's when you give credit to the supports. Nice observer right there. Seeing the OD farm, and Nyx Assassin just goes and gets that easy kill. Easy peasy kill. There is a Weaver here. We have a sentry, and with disables we are able to pick him off. He came to the lane trying to push out the lane and defend the tower maybe when the rest of his teammates respawn, but we had a nice sentry. Nice supports this game, very nice supports. Sentries, Lion got himself a really fast blink dagger, always in position to hex and stun people, and very, very useful. Just hit the tower a little bit. Where's my bloodlust? Bloodlust me. Okay, there it is. Meanwhile, Juggernaut is pressuring middle, so I know that. I know that the enemies will split trying to defend mid. So, I think I do take the tower here. I really should because I know there are three enemies mid. Weaver, Slark and Disruptor. Use Shrapnel to get vision of the tower and just right click the tower. When you know there is no backdoor protection, you can damage the tower, but you have no vision, just a shrapnel. And right now, I realized I was alone on the top lane. Bottom lane is pushing in a lot of easy farm, so just go and get it.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Easy and fast farm.
Kill.
And then enemies pick off the supports. It's a really good thing that Juggernaut didn't die at least. He really knew when to back and when to not go in.
Triple homicide.
It's kinda unfortunate that it's a triple kill for Slark. Like, if his teammates got some of the kills would be amazing, but triple kill for Slark. Slark is a scary hero when fat, when farmed with a lot of items. So here I'm watching the enemy. I'm watching the enemies. I know they are middle, so I can afford to go for one more push. Not with my hero though, but with a shrapnel, and then I can go back. Yeah, going back to base. It's always that one more creep wave. A lot of the times really risky because going for one more creep wave can get you killed. But if you know there are no enemies around, just get one more creep wave, push the lane into the tower, pressure the tower, space created. Enemies have to defend the tower. Okay, right here. My teammates smoked into Roche. Now, I'm not smoked. And what I don't want to do, what I shouldn't do, is casually walk into the Roche pit. That will literally tell my teammates, hey, we are Roching. If they have vision on me, I'm telling them, hey, we are Roching. Come kill us. So basically, I didn't even go to the pit because I wasn't smoked. Pinging the top lane tower, I think that's the right thing to do right now. Top lane tower is low HP, we can just go finish it for easy gold. The Hurricane Pike is ready by the way for me. So that's the mobility and escape ability and utility. Juggernaut with Helm of the Dominator has a wolf. That wolf has bonus damage aura that I also benefit from it a lot. Increases my damage by a lot as well.
Dire's top tower has fallen.
I was meant to have this.
By the way, my talents this game. Level 10 attack speed. With Ring of Aquila mana regen, you don't really need the plus 5 mana regen. We're trying to pick off the Slark here. But I don't think that's a kill. That doesn't look like a kill, no. My TP was pretty slow because Lion TP'd before me, so my TP... Okay, that was a completely wasted Omni Slash. Slark had his ultimate ready. I don't know why he Omni Slashed like that, but anyway. Trying to kill the Weaver. Hurricane Pike the Weaver, push him away from me. Okay, so we kill the OD. With the Juggernaut in your team, the healing ward is really, really useful. After a one team fight, you can heal your entire team with your healing ward. So after a one team fight and you have with the Juggernaut alive, you can always go push something. I said Level 10, 15 attack speed talent. On level 15, I went for the 20 shrapnel DPS. To me, at first, the plus 20 shrapnel DPS didn't seem like a lot, but believe me, it is a lot. If enemies stay under the shrapnel for more than 3 seconds, they will be taking a lot of damage. Basically, people have to move away. They have to leave the shrapnel area, or they take a lot of damage that they could avoid. So it forces enemies to move. That's the thing. Shrapnel deals more damage, forces enemies to move. It's like Underlord's Q, you know, the fire thing. You don't want to stay under the Underlord spell. It's not a good idea. So here we get a pick off on the Disruptor, Juggernaut with Skadi and Blink Dagger. And now Slark looks like he's gonna die as well. And buys back instantly. He's trying to defend. I got my Mjolnir ready. And I put it on the Juggernaut. I'm sitting all the way back and right clicking, so if they attack somebody, that will be Juggernaut, not me. So I just put my Mjolnir on Jug. Just right clicking the OD from very long distance. Getting the tower, OD buys back as well. At this point it's two buybacks. The OD and the Slark both carries. So even if we don't manage to get barracks, if we back and stay alive, it will be totally worth and totally won fight. Because they use buyback on both carries. Juggernaut will go down, but before that, that's a really nice Omni Slash, doing a lot of damage to everybody. And ultimate on OD doesn't really kill him. Okay, I thought Juggernaut will die, but no, we actually get the barracks. Oh, he has Aegis, my bad. I'm dead. Juggernaut had Aegis, okay, I didn't notice that. Now he's gonna die as well. How do you escape 3 heroes? You can't, right? You can't escape those 3 heroes, right? Yep, he's dead. So we could have backed after getting the melee rocks. That's a little bit of overextending there. Because we got rocks and we are really fat, we got a lot of gold. And every time enemies kill us now, they get a lot of gold because we have a pretty big advantage in net worth. 15,000 net worth advantage for us right now. So when I look here, Slark killed me, ended my 5 kill streak, and he also ended Juggernaut's 7 kill streak. That's why overextending is so bad. Because Slark just got Ogre kill, 300, 600, 1000. Slark got almost 2000 gold from that one fight. In 1 minute, Slark got almost 2000 gold. It's insane. So that's why overextending is bad. Destroy the buildings and get out. There is even a chat wheel command for that. Some people have it on their chat wheels. I don't. Should probably get it. It says destroy buildings and get back. Or destroy barracks? Destroy buildings, I think. And get back. That's a really good chat wheel command. Destroy buildings and get back. That's what should be done always.
Those people had families.
I won't forget this. So right now, we are kind of split. There is a mid lane fight going on, and I am pushing out the bottom lane, so this is not good. We died with 3 heroes and we couldn't kill any enemies. Pretty unfortunate. The bottom lane had to be defended, like somebody had to push it out.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
I'm going butterfly next item. Okay. So, when I was playing this game, this is what I thought. Normally, Slark is a good hero to carry an MKB, right? MKB that counters butterfly evasion. but he just finished his Cuddy. He won't have enough gold, like, he won't build the MKB fast enough. He just finished his Cuddy, and at this point of the game, he should also save gold for buyback. So, he won't have an MKB anytime soon on Slark. Weaver is an offlaner, he's not getting that much farm. He can't afford to get a fast MKB either. And OD is normally a hero that never gets MKB. Like, even if it's really, really, really needed, still OD doesn't get MKB because there are other items that benefit him a lot more than an MKB. OD is just not an MKB hero. And the 35% evasion from Butterfly is really good against OD. It blocks a lot of his attacks that are pure damage, and they deal a lot of damage. There was a nice little smoke here that got us a pick off on Weaver. And now we're going to push the top lane. Let's see what happens now. Nyx Assassin is set up with his Aghanim Scepter form. The Burrow, whatever, I don't know what it's called. And Juggernaut is gonna die, he got ulted by the Disruptor. Four staff myself away from the Kunkka boat, so I don't get stunned. Okay, we get the kill on Slark. OD Astros himself when I ult him, but that gives us time to catch him. He Astro himself and basically gave us time to walk on the high ground and just kill him after the Astro. Right now the Juggernaut is dead, and we don't have any building damage unless I hit buildings, so I know I should prioritize buildings here. It's very important to realize when to go for hero kills, when to go for buildings. So here my teammates are diving to create space. I am not diving with them to deal damage on heroes. I am focusing entirely on buildings because my Juggernaut is dead. If my Juggernaut was with us here, maybe I could be diving as well, killing enemy heroes, harassing enemy heroes, and Juggernaut the one destroying barracks, something like that. Or even help the Juggernaut destroy barracks faster. Here is when I use my force on a teammate, on Lion. I don't think it saves his life. There is an ultimate to kill Disruptor. There is a gem here on the ground. Slark and OD are still dead. But this is bad. Disruptor bought back. Oh, I actually made it. I actually survived. That's the Talisman of Evasion right there. So definitely this shrine should not be alive, first of all. We didn't kill it before going. But I guess if the enemy's carries are dead with no buyback, like in this case Lark and OD, we shouldn't waste time on a shrine. But because this shrine was still there, Disruptor bought back and tippied to it, came from behind, ulted me together with Kinetic Field, and basically killed... He killed my teammate, I escaped with very low HP. That's the value Talisman of Evasion. And I had this question on my stream after the game. Why Talisman of Evasion first as a part of the Butterfly? Why not the Eagle Song that costs 3000 damage and it gives you attack speed from agility, it gives you damage, it gives you armor? It's basically because, why am I getting the Butterfly this game? Because they have a lot of right clickers and evasion will be good against them. So I get the Talisman first and that evasion counters the right clickers. They miss attacks on me, so yeah. Sometimes it's good to get the Eagle Song first, it gives you damage. But sometimes it's better to get the Talisman of Evasion first. Now you might be thinking, you have both Mjolnir and Butterfly. Like, don't you want, like, do you really want evasion when you have Mjolnir? I don't see why not, to be honest, because they don't attack me that much. Oh shit. Okay, am I dead now that I say they don't attack me that much? No, I'm not dead. Or maybe the Slark kills me here? Yeah, the Slark kills me. Okay, that's a buyback. Ulti the Slark. And Slark actually started TPing there. I cancelled his TP, but can't really catch him. He's really fast when we don't have vision on him. Okay, this time the buyback was nice. Because Odie doesn't have a buyback and Weaver doesn't have a buyback. Looks like I knew that in the when I was playing the game. Sometimes you are not sure, but looks like I knew that during the game. So I buyback, join my team, and get the mega creeps, and that's it. And we get mega creeps now. The thing about Butterfly and Mjolnir, I can put Mjolnir on someone else. I can put it on Juggernaut. He goes in first. And by the way, I really like Juggernaut's item choices this game. He went for a Skadi, and I like that a lot because, as I mentioned earlier in this video, we don't have a very tanky frontliner like Axe or Centaur, so Juggernaut will be our frontliner sometimes, and going for Skadi gives him a lot of HP and makes him harder to kill, and he can tank more damage for us. He can go in and have that survivability with Manta, Eye of Skadi, Blink Dagger to go in. So that was the sniper game. 272 last hits, a lot of farm this game. Juggernaut number one on net worth, I mean the safe lane carry, his job is to farm. So he's number one on net worth. I do have a lot more damage done to heroes though, and more damage done to buildings. We're kinda similar, but I had more. Get wrecked. I had more. 38,000 hero damage in a 39 minutes game. That seems really good. Had a really good game here. Really nice and really fun sniper game. And I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope it was useful in a way, and I hope you learned something that you didn't know before. So thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, a like would be really appreciated. If you're new to my channel, subscribe here. I try to upload videos every day. See you in the next one. Good luck and have fun playing video games.